What's going on, and welcome back. First and foremost, my name is Josh LaPresse, and I just want to say thank you for tuning in to another episode of Fish and Fowl Florida. As you guys can see, today I'm not in Florida. I'm at the duck camp in Sumner, Missouri with my buddy here, Dom. And tomorrow, we're going to get into some serious duck hunting action, so stay tuned to see what happens. You! So we went out this morning and we tried the wood duck hole, but the conditions that were predicted are actually a little bit off. I mean, per usual, weathermen are never right, but it was predicted a 10 mile an hour northeast wind. We're getting more of a straight east wind with a little bit more behind it than 10 mile an hour. So making some adjustments here. We're in the big pit, and hopefully this decoy adjustment gives these birds a little bit of a different look because they're being a bit finicky with this weather. What do we got going on here?
Little taster test. Little breakfast burritos.
We got him flicking the wrist and calling ducks at the same time. It's Mr. Andy Boyle. Five star right there, baby. You make the call. My gun just clicked. F***ing A. I can't. You shoot him, I can't shoot. My gun's not shit firing. Dude, there's something wrong with the cycling in this f***ing gun. Are they in the decoy? Alright, I'm gonna try it again. Let me know when you're ready. Welcome to day number two of our Missouri hunting trip. Day one didn't pan out as we planned, but hey, that's hunting, and I'm gonna here to keep it real with you. Today, our conditions, we got south to southeast winds, about 5 to 8 mile an hour gusts, and it's gonna switch to northeast. Still sitting on a bunch of new birds. Little better conditions than yesterday in terms of weather, but if you're a duck hunter, you know that foul weather is a good thing. So we're gonna go get in the pit and we'll see what happens.
They're gonna do it.
There you go, nice mallard drake, double curl, and the hen as well. First two mallards of the trip. There we go, duck number three. Beautiful little Drake Greenwing.
Let me shoot her.
There we go, good one. He's alive. Get up. Go, Josh.
I got him. Beautiful immature Drake pintail there for duck number four. Beauty. Had a couple teal come in, lost sight of them, and then they swung back around quick, and I couldn't get the camera turned on in time, but nice little greenwing there. See if we can't get some more. Again, couldn't get the camera on in time, but nice hen mallard. See what else we can do. Looks like another Drake Greenwing. Oh no, it looks like it's a hen. Immature Drake. Little guy. But hey, let's hope we can keep it going.
What?
Can you hand me two more shells? I'm gonna walk that way. No way! I got a snow goose! Woo! Yeah, baby! It's my first freaking snow goose! Let's go! Let's go! Woo! Oh, no way! No f***ing way! No way. No freaking way. As a Floridian, I don't shoot any geese at all. And I'll tell you what, that is unreal. We saw two teal drop in at the backside of the corn, and I went to go jump shoot them. I seen a white bird fly up. I thought it was a mallard, a albino one. Oh my God. But it's a freaking goose. I'm freaking stoked. No way. No way. That is so cool. That is so cool. So here's what we got on the stringer in the south blind. And upon further inspection, this goose that was in the cornfield that I jump shot had freaking a bunch of corn in his mouth. is in there feeding by himself. And if you guys know anything about these snow geese, they usually travel in huge flocks. I'll throw in a clip of one of the big flocks that we've seen earlier this trip, but he was in there lonesome just feeding. As you can see, there's a few kernels sticking out right there. But a nice little stack so far. Let's see if we can keep her going. So here's how we finished out for day two. Not a terrible shoot. The boys in the north pit blind actually left early today around 12 o'clock with a few other ducks that we had shot, a pintail, a couple more mallards, and a few more teal. So overall, not a bad shoot. I mean, we had 6-7 guys, but hey, that's hunting. We ended up with a good little bag of ducks here and my first goose, so I'm super stoked on that. And actually, this guy right here, we crippled him and thought we lost him, but on the way out on the Argo, we ended up seeing him laid up in the corn. So good little find there. Beautiful green wing drake. I'm pretty sure I shot this one too, so nice little gem there. We don't get many of these in Florida all fully plumed out, so that's pretty sweet. We got one more day tomorrow, and I'm gonna go ahead and clean these up, and I'll get back with you guys tomorrow. Hopefully we have a freaking barrel burner tomorrow. If not, hey, that's hunting. Day three in the duck blind. Everybody else left today. It's just me and my dad. It's our last hunt of the trip, so we'll see if we can make it happen. We got 30 degree weather, 5 to 10 mile an hour wind out of the west. But the big difference today is we have no overcast conditions. We have blue skies, so hopefully we'll see the sun, and hopefully that'll make the difference in a good kill today. So stay tuned, and once it gets lighter, we'll put you right back on the dome and hopefully get some good shots in.
Right here. Got him. That was a hell of a shot. I'll go grab that. That was crazy. Nice shot. Got him. Greenhead Drake. First duck of the third hunt. And he's a beautiful greenhead drake. Long shot, I can't believe my dad hit this thing, but hey, first one on the board. My dad just did an over the back jack. Hold on. Oh, he was live. Wow. My dad shot this and I got him on the water swat, I think, but he's so lively. What a beautiful freaking duck. Absolute beauty. Let me put my gun on my shoulder so you guys can see this thing. I mean, it doesn't get much prettier than that right there. This thing is freaking gorgeous. So we got two ducks on the board. It's probably not even 7:30 yet, and we got a nice woody and a nice drake mallard. had to give you guys one more look at this thing. I mean, absolute stunner of a duck right there. I'm not gonna claim it. I did water swat it. My dad knocked her down, or knocked him down. But I mean, all around, from beak to freaking tail to underwing feathers, I mean, this thing is a freaking stunner. Absolute beauty. Nice shot, Dad. How good, grab her. She worked nice. One shot drop from my dad on this Susie. We got two mallards, one hen, one drake, and a nice wood duck. Pretty good shoot so far, I would say. And let's hope it keeps going this way. That bluebird sky and the sun coming out finally, and this is the third day, so we haven't seen the sun in 3 days, man. But hey, it's making a difference now, and that's why we call it hunting. That was crazy. Not much else to say, but that's what you're looking for when you're looking for working birds. It was a group of gadwalls with some mallards mixed in. I dropped this hen probably like 15, 20 yards. Absolutely beautiful. Let's hope we can get more working birds like that. He's still up. I got another shell. It dove down. Oh no, it's right behind the decoy.
I got the green head.
Did you drop it?
Yeah, right there.
Oh shit, I didn't even see that. Nice job. That's how we do it. Two mallards in, two mallards down. I didn't even see my dad shot the green head, but I got this one. Nice hen. Now we're gonna go pick up the drake. There you go. The hen and the drake. We got them both.
We didn't even see these freaking things until they were right on us, and we dropped them both. Beautiful little pair. And that makes six ducks, four mallards, a gadwall, and a wood duck. So we're doing pretty good. Let's hope we can finish it out before 1 o'clock. Go in and get some coffee.
Me and my dad were just eating muffins and had a duck 10 yards, and we got him. So this is duck number 7. I think it's a widgeon, but I'm absolutely not sure. But he was freaking floating over the decoys, and it's funny because last night I heard a bunch of widgeons sitting on a field, and I was like, where are these things? Looks like we got one. Yeah, it's a widgeon. Beauty. It's a hen, but it's a widgeon. Beautiful mixed bag. I mean, you can't ask for anything more. We got 7 birds, and we got 1, 2, 3. I think this is the 4th species and 7 birds. I mean, that's pretty sweet. Beautiful widgeon. You ask for them and they'll come. You deuced them. Yeah. They were watching him from the backside. They were swinging around.
Oh, it's a band!
So I hope I got that on camera. We were working a group of mallards and this one came in over the top floating, and
are you
kidding? Look at that, my dad just
number
shot a freaking banded mallard. That's his 3rd freaking band in 2 weeks, but that's the first band I've ever picked up in my life. That is freaking crazy. Here, hold this sucker. Get a good footage of you. Look at that.
Pretty cool. It's 2 weeks.
He was just beating himself up over not letting the group work, but look at that. He freaking made it count, and he got some jewelry for himself.
Big boy.
We'll go ahead and punch that in when we get back to the cabin, and I'll throw up the location he was banded up on the video. But freaking awesome. That's our 8th duck. I think that's our 5th mallard. Let's see if we can finish and scratch out a limit here. And that is going to conclude our Sumner, Missouri duck hunting trip. And I could not be more stoked with the way that this hunt turned out for me and my dad. He ended up with some bling on this beautiful Drake greenhead. We ended up with 3 greenheads, 2 Susies, a hen gaddy, a stunner of a Drake wood duck, and an immature Drake widgeon upon further inspection. I just want to say thank you guys for tuning in to another episode of Fish and Fowl Florida. You guys watching these videos means the absolute world to me, because your support means you guys are supporting my dream. And with that being said, I just wanted to tell you guys that although the idea behind hunting is the kill, it's not always about that. You know, we were presented some really tough conditions over this trip over the past 3 hunts, and we didn't kill any limits, and that's all right, you know, that's reality. And what hunting's really about is the atmosphere, the people around you, and the camaraderie. And through this video, I hope you guys get a little bit of taste of that. And I hope you guys get a little taste of what it's like to hunt out of state. And you know what? We're going to get back to Florida and we're going to get back after it. But until then, that's a wrap. And I'll see you guys in that next video.